Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Wednesday, June 1st, 2011. I'm a little late this morning and I'm going to do a condensed version of the presentation. Had some technical issues, was away for a few days, and I thought everything would start up the way that I left it last week, but unfortunately that's not the way computers work. And so in the pre-market this morning we had futures go out pretty close to their morning lows. The S&P futures down about 6 points, so we're going to open lower this morning. And we ended May on a positive note. All of the major indexes are now on buy signals. We do have that end of month bias. That's all that automatic money that is taken off people's paychecks, and that usually flows into their pension accounts and their retirement accounts, and that usually flows directly into the stock market. And even if the market does want to go lower, that end of month money flow helps reduce the losses. So you never hear of a market crashing at the end of the month or the start of a new month. June, unfortunately, is the worst month of the year. I know September and October have the worst reputations, and that, of course, is because of the major crashes that have happened during those months. But historically, June's the worst month, and in fact, we've closed lower the last 6 years in a row for the month of June. Now, coming into June, we're doing pretty good. We got the VIX on a sell signal. That's bullish. All the major indexes closed on Tuesday above the upper channel line. So we've got a buy signal for the Dow, buy signal for the S&P 500. The NASDAQ came up just to the previous peak that we had a couple of weeks ago. That's at the 2375 resistance level. Now, I'm short the NASDAQ. I'm short some of these major indexes using leveraged ETFs. I also have some puts on the Qs. So now's the time and place to take care of those. Luckily, we're going to open lower this morning, and that where we're opening doesn't indicate any possibility of a sell signal. It's just a lower open on Wednesday morning, and so we're going to be able to cover some of our short positions at lower prices and buy at lower prices than where we closed out on Tuesday. So we saw some strength last week in the Russell, in the Zacks microcap. They're all on buy signals. Even bank stocks came back and generated a buy signal. Now, it's funny, the European banks are doing really well. U.S. banks are still dragging at the moment. Now, of course, if I had my choice between putting money into financial U.S. financial stocks or U.S. energy stocks, of course, I'd be a lot more interested in putting it in energy stocks. We were able to move higher there on Tuesday as well. No change for gold stocks on Tuesday. Semiconductors, big up day on Tuesday. We're now back on a buy signal for the chip sector. Credit card stocks had some weakness last week, came back on Friday and on Tuesday. And so the credit card stocks are up, testing the previous two highs there. And so we'll have to see how they handle resistance on Wednesday. Looking at bonds, no change here. Still trading above the 125 level. A close below 124.60 would kick us out on Wednesday. U.S. dollar, still some weakness there. A new low for this move yesterday. A close above 75.82 on the U.S. dollar index would give us a buy signal. And the euro, second day of a buy signal, a close below 141 would change things on Wednesday. Take a look at Wednesday's roadmap. Looking at the VIX, we're down at the bottom of the panic zones. We've got pressure zones forming. This is the time and place where we look for the VIX to reverse move higher, and that, of course, will put downward pressure on stocks. So we're hoping that doesn't happen. First sign that something's changing is if the VIX starts moving above 17 on an hourly basis. Looking at the S&P 500 cash index, we're up at previous resistance. No early warning signal from Tuesday's trading. We're going to remain bullish on the S&P 500 cash index as long as it continues to trade above 1330. We start breaking down below that point, then you know that the bears are back in control on a short-term basis. First sign of weakness on Wednesday is going to be an hourly close below 1333.86. Looking at the NASDAQ 100, first sign of weakness on Wednesday is going to be an hourly close below 2345.82. And the first sign of weakness for U.S. bank stocks and the S&P Bank Index is going to be an hourly close below 139.30. Okay, that's all for Wednesday morning. June's the worst month of the year, but we're starting off on the right foot. We're on buy signals right now, so we need to cover our shorts for anything that received a buy signal yesterday and go long this market. I don't think the opportunities to the upside are that great. Look for a move up to recent highs if we can continue and don't break down on Wednesday. I would look for a move up to the recent highs over the next week or so, and then a move down into the end of June. Okay, that's all for Wednesday morning, folks. Have a great day. We'll talk to you again on Thursday morning.